Power 93.7 WBLK. I'm Yasmin Young. This is the 2 to 6 Takeover, and I am joined by a very special guest. You already know her. I shouldn't even have to introduce her, but I'm talking about Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul. Welcome.
Yasmin, thanks for having me back on the show. I always enjoy our conversations.
And I always appreciate you checking back in back home here in Western New York. Now, I saw a letter that you wrote in the Buffalo News, and we're going to talk about that because I really think that it was so powerful in talking about how our small businesses have been affected by COVID-19. And you really were passionate about that. But before we get to that, I want to talk about where we are in Western New York when it comes to how we've been handling COVID-19 and this, if you would call it second wave, or some say that the first wave never stopped.
Well, that's a great question. And yes, this remains forefront in our minds because the numbers are not going down. You know, a slight decrease in the number of people infected, but that meant an increase in the number of people heading into hospitals. And once you head into a hospital, and if you end up in an ICU, that's a very desperate situation because there's not really a good outcome. And what we're seeing, particularly, you know, communities of color have been hardest hit. They have a higher infection rate, higher death rate. So we are just really encouraging everyone to, as much as you're absolutely sick and tired of being away from your loved ones and you want to hug people and you want to take that darn mask off, now is not the time. We do see an end in sight. We know that with the vaccine just around the corner, we're going to be able to vaccinate our most vulnerable first, our elderly, our healthcare workers, our nursing home occupants, and then eventually want everyone to take advantage of it. But right now, our numbers in much of Erie County are about 7.8%. Some of the areas are 8%, 9%. And that's very frightening. That means everybody's going to know somebody who either has it now or had it in the past. And that's, we foresaw this, but we're really getting hit hard. There's no other way to sugarcoat that.
Absolutely. And a lot of folks, you know, when we went into being an orange zone, a lot of folks were upset because obviously things had to close down or reduce their occupancy. But that is one of the, or should be at least one of the motivators among many other motivators to help us understand that this is serious and to take it serious so that, you know, our economy can thrive here in Western New York. And I really appreciated your letter because you were talking about how, you know, we still can support the businesses here in Western New York, even if we're not physically going into them. So can you talk about, you know, how you encourage people to support those businesses that may be struggling during this time?
Yes, and they are struggling. You know, everyone had to be shut down unless you were an essential business. But basically all the small mom and pop retails, the barber shops, the hair salons, the nail salons and little gift shops, they all had to close early in the summer, late in the spring, until we can get to a better place. And a lot of them thought they were going to make up their lost revenues during the holiday season. I come from a family that has started a small flower and gift shop, and they are desperately afraid that if they get completely shut down during this time, they may not survive. And they've been there since, you know, I helped my mother start them a long time ago. So there's a lot of businesses that are on the cusp of either making it or breaking it right now. And what we can do is, if it's a restaurant, if you're not able to eat indoors, buy a gift certificate. That's a fabulous gift to give one of your loved ones. It's hopeful. It says that there will be a point where we can dine in together. It may be a few months down the road, but at least that helps get cash into the hands of our businesses right now. Gift cards are a great idea as well. Just if you don't want to go into a shop, buy a gift card online or walk in and get it very quickly. But if you do go into a shop, they'll be following the protocols. You'll be safe. Just wear the masks and stay a distance from everybody. So if we don't hang on now, if we don't help them survive now, our downtowns, whether you shop on the east side or Elmwood Village or, wherever you do your shopping over on Hurdle, they will not make it. They will not make it. And what a ghost town this would be if we didn't have the vibrant small businesses that add so much charm to our communities.
It's so important. It's so important to make sure that these businesses are able to survive this storm. And as you said, there is, an end in sight. We've just got to be patient and make it through. And I know that New York State is committed to supporting small businesses. Can you talk about the New York Forward Loan Fund and the Empire State Digital Project?
Yes, both are very important. First of all, the digital project, many businesses didn't expect to ever sell their products online. And this has actually made companies, businesses become very creative, or people that are just laid off from their jobs that are finding new hobbies or crafts that they actually can find a market for, but they don't have any idea how to set up their digital platform, how to, you know, do whatever it takes to just have an online presence. So we do in our NYForward.gov website, encourage people to go check it out. You might be able to get some great advice. But you can also check out our small business loan programs on that site as well. And there's also a direct grants from Erie County. I know a number of them were just allocated from the federal dollars. Over $19 million went directly to over 1,000 small businesses in West New York to help them hang on. Another issue that's really important is continuation of unemployment insurance for the people who are not back at their jobs, whether it's in hospitality, whether it's in working in a restaurant. A lot of people still lay off from their jobs. The unemployment benefits are due to expire, and we're trying very hard to get them. Otherwise, 12 million Americans will be losing their health, not their health, their unemployment benefits by the end of December. Can you imagine what a Christmas gift that is? Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden be flat broke. And these are tough times for our people. They really, truly are. And supporting them in any way you can, and if you need help yourself, there's help out there for you, but we just have to pull through. But I think what's really important, Yasmin, is to remind people that this vaccine is critically important. When it is available, we need 75 to 80% of Americans to go for it, have it, be vaccinated, and to ensure that we can get everybody safe. And then we can say, we finally won this war, it's over, and we can get back to a full economy where everybody's back to their jobs, the small businesses are protected, and we can just put this very, very challenging chapter behind us.
Absolutely. If you would, give out that web address one more time.
NYForward.gov.
Okay. And we've got that link on our website as well, WBLK.com. Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul, it's always a pleasure. Thank you so much for updating us and for giving us these tools and resources that we can use here in Western New York to weather this storm.
Thank you very much for having me. And let's catch up again before the holidays.